a lot of competition here today. We've got the bikies out doing their bike run with their Harley Davidson, making a lot of noise. And then the magpies are going to come around again and praise the Lord. I can hear a bird just up there a while ago. But the one that comes through nice and strong is nothing but the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah for that. Thank you, Lord, we've got the cleansing blood. Isn't the Lord good? We're on the winning team. We're on the winning side. Good to see Barney. Won the Wimbledon Championship. Australia does win sometimes. Australia has been also known as the Great Southland of the Holy Spirit. And at the moment, it's under severe attack. Viruses, sick people, all sorts of problems. But we will get through. How do you know that, Rudy? My Bible tells me so. If you've got any problems, this is where you go. If you're having a bad run, like some of you are, and some of us are, I include myself in that, we all have bad runs from time to time. We all get little sicknesses, maybe a little bit of flu here and there. But I got a good word from the Lord the other day, and it says, just get over it. Just get over it. The Lord seemed to say to me, oh, the magpies. Every time I come out now, you must like the sound of my voice. You just got to get over it. Whatever the problem is, no matter how high or how low, how long, how wide, how short, just get over it. Trusted that song a few weeks ago. He has not given to us the spirit. Oh yes, the magpies are right on cue. You have not given to us the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. So get that sound mind together so that you can get over it. Rejoice in the Lord. The Lord's coming soon, so just be ready. Might be today, why not? Everything's all set there. Everything's all set. Might be next month, next year. Who knows? Nobody knows the day nor the hour. But we see the indications. Okay, magpie, I don't know what I'm going to do with you, but you're praising the Lord every time I come out. Praise the Lord. What's your ministry, birds? You know the Lord had used birds for a ministry? Yes, he does. Noah was in the ark and the flood, and he sent out the little dove to see if there was dry land. And he went out and he came back, no dry land. And then he sent him out again a couple of weeks later, and he came back with a little fig tree. A fig leaf, not a tree. I'm just getting over the flu. I'm just fighting that off. I'm getting over it. Just get over it, Roddy. Brought back a little leaf. Many times in the Bible, the Lord has used birds. He's even fed his servants. Oh, I think we just listen to the birds, eh? Praise the Lord. You don't need me. Magpies are doing a great job. I wonder what they're saying to us today. So birds were used quite a bit in the Bible. Even these sparrows and... you go through the scripture, all the birds, the Lord uses the birds. He uses the animals too. Okay, just a short reading today. Have you got over it yet? You feel a bit depressed? Get over it. Got a bit of flu hanging on, a bit of bad cold, a bit of sneezing. Things haven't gone too good for you today. I've got my Australia cap on. Because Australia won the tennis. Great Southland of the Holy Spirit. Hooray for Australia. Hooray for the whole wide world. We need the gospel, regardless. Precious blood that flowed from Calvary. We just heard that song. Oh, precious is the blood that flowed down, that saved a wretch like me. So let's read from Psalm 86, verse 10. For you are great and do wondrous things. You alone are God. Teach me your way, O Lord, that I may walk in your truth. Give me an undivided heart to revere your name. I give thanks to you, O Lord my God, with my whole heart. I will glorify your name forever. I'll get a magpie right coming close. Oh, isn't that beautiful? It's like a daddy magpie too, a big fat one. Must be getting, someone must be feeding him around here. For great is your steadfast love towards me. You have delivered my soul from the depths of Sheol. Another way of putting it, from the depths of hell. O God, the insolent rise up against me. A band of ruffians seek my life. Oh, that's not very good. Is that true? Yes, that's true. And they do not set you before them. That's true. But you, O Lord, are a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness. That's good qualities that our God has. That's the one whom we serve. Steadfast love and faithfulness. Even though sometimes we might be not full of faithfulness. Maybe you're getting weary, you little YouTube viewers, you flickers. Maybe you're getting tired waiting for this, for the Lord to take you to heaven, to be with him forever. But you've got to endure to the end. You've got to get over it. Same as I do, I have to get over it. I'm an old man now, pretty well worn out. Ready for the nursing home, some people think. They think, when are you going to sell up here and retire into one little village, those little retirement villages? I say, no, thank you for asking. I'm quite happy here with the magpies. Turn to me, verse 16. Turn to me and be gracious to me. Give your strength to your servant. So I need some more strength. Get over it and get some more strength. Save the child of your serving girl. Oh, you never heard that. Didn't know that was in the Bible, did you? That's referring to my darling mother, who's up in heaven now. I'll just read that again. You've never heard that before. Save the child of your serving girl. My dear mother served from 18 years of age to 93 years of age, when she went to be with the Lord, which the Bible said is far better. Oh, little, oh yes, why do you do this? They're little rainbow lorikeets, that was, a little flock of rainbow lorikeets. If you're interested in the birds, they're all multicoloured. They consider them vermin in Australia, but I love them. They eat all the fruit off the tree, they eat all my what have I got? I've got pears, they come and nibble the pear tree, the mulberry tree, and then I've got the, a couple of other fruit trees out there. Anyway, let's stick with the message. Save the child of your serving girl. That's my dear mother referring to that. She brought me up in the ways of the Lord. Do not depart from me, you old. You will not depart from my old. And I'm not departing from here. Thank you very much for asking. Even though we have a band of ruffians seeking my life. A band of ruffians. Oh Lord, you'll have to deal with them, take them out. We don't want them hanging around. Show me a sign of your favour. Oh, give me a sign, Lord. What is it, the parrots coming around whistling? So that those who hate me may see it and be put to shame. I don't want to put you to shame, I just want you to get born again. So I can meet you in heaven. When I get to heaven, I'll have lots of friends, won't I? Oh, I've got a lot of friends from the old days. They're all dead and gone. All dear pastors and elders and deacons and people on the mission. Oh, I've got a great team of friends already gone. They've been gone a long time, some of them. Little Kenny, the singer, he's gone. Show me a sign of your favour so that those who hate me may see it and be put to shame. Because you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me. Get over it. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for the precious blood. Thank you, Jesus, that you died on the cross. Thank you, Jesus, that we can be born again by faith and by believing and confessing before three witnesses at least, or if not more, and keep saying, Lord, we love you because you first loved us and you died on the cross. You shed your blood. You're wounded for my transgressions. Your blood flowed down. You had a wounded side. You wore the crown of thorns. You took our punishment, Lord, and we're brought back into the family of God, and we rejoice today. We've got over all our problems. Thank you, Jesus, for this new week. Thank you for this time that we have before you come and take us. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Rejoice, rejoice, rejoice. Let everybody rejoice. Let everybody rejoice.